Hey, what's up? Welcome again to a very exciting and stunning tutorial. Today we are actually going to be creating this very interesting 3D volume light effect inside of After Effects with very basic techniques without using any third-party plugins. Look at this. I mean, wow. I am super excited. Let's jump right into the After Effects and create this together step by step. Before we get started, I request you to please subscribe to my channel so that you don't miss updates. Please do check my other tutorials as well. These tutorials include the project files which you can download free of cost. One more request, can I get just 100 likes for this masterpiece? It's free of cost. It will not cost you anything and it will really help me a lot. Okay, without any further ado, let's get started. Create a new composition, name it main comp, select the preset HDTV 1080, change the frame rate to 30 and the duration to 5 seconds and hit OK. Create a new solid layer for the background, change its color whatever you like and name it BG and hit OK. Create another solid layer and name it floor. Switch the floor layer to 3D. Press the R key to open up the rotation properties and change the X rotation to minus 90 degrees. Click on the text tool, type your text and align it with the floor layer. Right click on the text layer and select pre-compose. Now again make this layer 3D. Create a camera, go to layer, new, hit camera option. I will take 50mm lens. Now align the floor and the text comp approximately to the center of the screen. Select the floor layer and go to effects and preset panel and find the effect motion tile and double click on it to apply it to the floor layer. Change the motion tile output width to 200 and output height to 400. To create a light, go to layer menu, then new and click the light tab. Keep the light type point and hit OK. Expand the point light options and turn the cast shadow on. Select the text comp, hit AA on keyboard and turn the cast shadow on for it. Now adjust the light position, move it back in the Z space or up down or left and right until you get the perfect look. To avoid the sharp edges of the shadow, just open up the point light settings again and increase the shadow diffuse as much as you like. Create a new solid, change its color to white and name it light source. Click the ellipse tool and create a mask like this. Switch the light source layer to 3D. Now hit AA and switch the accept lights off and move it back in the Z space. We can see the light source layer is cutting off by the floor layer. To solve it, just change the floor layer mode to screen. Now create a new adjustment layer and rename it to volume light. Now go to the effects and preset panel and find an effect called CC Radial Fast Blur. Change the zoom option from standard to brightest and change the amount a bit higher, something like this. To decrease the blur effect, as we see it is unnecessarily affecting our text, go to effects and preset panel and find curves effect and apply it to the volume light layer. Move the curves effect above the CC Radial Blur effect and change the RGB curve to something like this. And change the layer mode to screen. Apply the curves effect again and this time tweak the red channel curves to increase the red tone. Now create a null object. Go to layer, then new null object and name it point, then switch it to 3D. Select the volume light layer. Go to the effects controller and alt click the stopwatch next to the center option under CC radial blur to add some expressions to it. Click and drag the pick with spiral, release the mouse button over the point layer and add a little expressions dot to comp open parenthesis bracket 0, 0, 0, close bracket close parenthesis. Now you can see we have attached the rays to this null object. We will use it later. Create a new solid layer and name it clouds and hit OK. Find the effect fractal noise and apply it to the cloud layer. Change the fractal type to dynamic Go to subsettings and change the subrotation to near about 150 degree. Select the ellipse tool and create a mask and feather it a bit high. Go to effects and preset panel, find the solid composite and double click it to apply. Change the solid color to black. To get rid of this weird looking gray, let's change the fractal noise blending mode from normal to none. Now change the blending mode of the cloud layer to screen. Switch it to 3D, then hit AA on the keyboard, change the accept lights from on to off. Move the cloud layer below the text layer. Now apply the curves effect and increase the red channel intensity. Okay, for your information, in the description of this tutorial, I will share this project file link so that you can download it free of cost and use it in your projects. To add some animation to the clouds, go to fractal noise. Alt-click the stopwatch next to the evolution to open up the script editor and type time times 150. Let's see the animation we just added. Select the cloud layer, go to edit and click duplicate. Push this new cloud layer back in Z space, scale it really big and adjust it to create some depth in the scene. Adjust the RGB curves and decrease the fractal noise brightness to lower down the brightness. Again, duplicate the cloud layer one more time and push it back in Z space and scale it really high. Decrease the fractal noise brightness and boost the red channel under the curves effect. Now make a duplicate of text layer. Move this layer above the volume light layer. Go to the effects and preset panel. Find the effect fill. Apply fill and change the color whatever you like. I will go with the dark reddish to match the scene. Again, find and apply an effect called bevel alpha in the effects and preset panel. Adjust the edge thickness and light angle, something like this, and increase the light intensity accordingly. Change the layer blending mode to screen. Wow, it looks stunning. Now create an adjustment layer, name it environment. We will apply curves effect to it to give a similar tone to the whole scene. Apply curves effect to the environment layer and in the curve setting, select the red channel, boost it until you like the effect. Let's work on the floor layer a bit to make it beautiful. Duplicate the floor layer. In the effects and preset panel, find the effect grid and apply it to the floor duplicate layer. Change the border setting to 3 and rename this layer grid. Move this layer up above the volume light layer and right under the text layer. Now we have a small problem. We can clearly see the grid through the text. To fix it, let's duplicate the text layer. Now select the grid layer and change its track matte to alpha inverted. Here we go. We just fixed the problem. To make the text look like 3D, select the main text layer and duplicate it. Select the bottom layer and hit AA on the keyboard and switch the accept lights to off and the cast shadow to off too. Push this layer back in 3D Z space until you get some fake 3D text effect. Let's animate the camera now. Select the camera, add a keyframe for point of interest and position value. Select the camera orbit tool and adjust the starting camera angle and position. Now select the point layer, adjust its starting position and set a keyframe. Now go to 3 seconds mark and again select the camera orbit tool and adjust the camera. Hold down the shift key while rotating the camera to avoid any weird results. Now again select the point layer and adjust its position. Let's preview the animation now. Wow! Amazing! Okay, that's all for now. I hope you guys like it. If you like what I'm doing, please support me and subscribe to my channel Motion Mango. I will share the project file link in the description below so that you can download it free of cost. I promise you that I will continue delivering the unique and interesting tutorials for you guys. The only thing I need is your support. You can share this tutorial with your friends and hit the like button and please do comment below. Signing off for now. We'll be right back with another exciting tutorial for you guys. Till then, take care.